One of the most common questions you're going to experience when you're doing the rate laws unit is determining the units for your rate constant K. So I'm going to show you how to do that. We're going to start with a zero order reaction. You need to know that rate is actually the change in molarity over time. So I'm going to use seconds. It could be minutes, which means since it's zero order, K is molarity per second. Sometimes you may see molarity written as moles per liter, and then you throw in seconds in the denominator. So that's the units for K. Now when it comes to first order, it's still molarity per second, but now we have a molarity unit over here. So K times a molarity unit. So what we're gonna do is we're just going to bring this over the other side in the denominator. What happens is you're just gonna cancel out your molarities. So the units for K is 1/2 seconds or 1/2 time. If you're given minutes, it's 1/2 minutes. I just pick seconds. For a second order reaction, it's still molarity per second, and now these two together is molarity squared. So you bring this over the other side, and we're only going to knock out one of the molarities. So it's K is equal to 1/molarity seconds. If we're going to put moles and liters in there, it comes out to liters over mole seconds, because molarity is moles per liter. And the last one I'm going to do is a third order rate law. So molarity per second is equal to K, and I just picked this, Z times Q squared, which is really just going to be molarity cubed. So we're going to bring that over to the denominator, molarity cubed, and knock out one of these. So it comes out to K is equal to 1/molarity squared seconds, and that would also be liter squared over mole squared seconds, or minutes. You can change the time, whatever you're given in your problem. And that's how you determine the units for the rate constant K. Okay.